हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम सुप्रिया घोषल, फैकल्टी मेंबर ऑफ श्री रामकृष्ण इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। टुडे आई हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक दैट इज बेयरिंग कैपेसिटी ऑफ सॉइल। इन दिस स्लाइड आई हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द बेयरिंग कैपेसिटी ऑफ सॉइल एंड सम इम्पॉर्टेंट डेफिनेशन विच इज रिलेटेड टू दिस टॉपिक। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू नो वट इज मीन बाई बेयरिंग कैपेसिटी ऑफ सॉइल। In geotechnical engineering, bearing capacity is the capacity of soil to support the loads applied to the ground. It is maximum average contact pressure between the foundation and the soil, which should not produce shear failure in the soil. In other words, we say that the maximum load per unit area which the soil can carry without yielding or displacement is termed as bearing capacity of soil. Then we have to know what is the definition of gross loading intensity or Q. This is the intensity of total pressure at the base of footing due to the load from the superstructure, self-weight of footing and the weight of earth fill above the base of footing. Next, that is net loading intensity. Before the construction of footing, the soil at the foundation level is subjected to an overburden pressure due to self-weight of the soil mass. The net loading intensity is the difference between the gross loading intensity and the overburden pressure. If footing is found in a soil mass having the unit weight gamma at the depth d below the ground level, then Qn equal to Q minus gamma into D. Then next definition is ultimate bearing capacity. This is the minimum intensity of loading at the base of the foundation which will cause a shear failure of the soil. Next, net ultimate bearing capacity. This is the minimum net pressure intensity due to applied load. The excluding and the existing overburden pressure which will cause a shear failure. And next one is net safe bearing capacity or QNS. The minimum net pressure intensity at the base of footing with respect to a specified factor of safety against shear failure. So the formula is QNS equal to QNF by F. QNF means net ultimate bearing capacity by factor of safety. This is the continuation of first slide. In this slide, the next definition is safe bearing capacity or QS, the maximum gross loading intensity which the footing safely carried without the risk of shear failure, irrespective the magnitude of failure. So the formula of safe bearing capacity, that is QS, equal to QNF by F plus gamma into D. F means factor of safety, gamma means unit weight of soil, and D equal to depth of foundation. And the next definition is allowable bearing capacity or QA. This is the net intensity of loading which the foundation will carry without undergoing settlement in excess of the permissible value but not exceeding the net safe bearing capacity. In this slide, I have discussed about Terzaghi's analysis assumptions and formula. Terzaghi's bearing capacity theory. Based on Terzaghi's bearing capacity theory, the column load, that is P, is restricted by shear stress at edge of three zone under the footing and the overburden pressure, that is Q equal to G into D. Here G is abbreviation of gamma, that is Q equal to gamma into D, and gamma means unit weight of soil above the footing. The first term in the equation is related to cohesion of the soil, and the second term is related to the depth of footing and overburden pressure, and the third term is related to the width of footing and the length of shear stress area. The bearing capacity factor, that is NC, NQ, N gamma, are function of internal friction angle, that is F. And the failure mechanism is, here we see the three type of zone we have already discussed. Zone 1 is soil wedge underfooting, zone 2 is plastic zone, and 3 is passive zone. Zone 1, a relatively unformed wedge of soil below the foundation from an active Rankine zone with angles 45 degree plus 5/2. Zone 2, that is the transition zone, take the form of long spherical fans. And zone 3, the wedge pushes soil outward, causing the passive Rankine zone to form with angle 45 degree minus 5/2. In this slide, I have discussed about Terzaghi's bearing capacity equation. The basic equation is Qf equal to Cnc plus gamma d Nq plus 0.5 gamma b N gamma, where C equal to cohesion of soil, Nc equal to bearing capacity factor due to cohesion of soil, gamma means unit weight of soil, d means depth of footing from GL, Nq means bearing capacity factor due to surges, b means base weight of footing, N gamma means bearing capacity factor due to unit weight of soil. And here Nc, Nq, N gamma depends upon angle of shearing resistance, that is phi of soil. And here Nc, Nq, N gamma, that is the coefficient, or it's a dimensionless number also known as bearing capacity. So here in this slide, I have discussed three type of footing, that is strip footing. So the formula of strip footing is Qu equal to Cnc plus G into, or gamma into D Nq plus 0.5 gamma B N gamma. Next is square footing. The formula is Qu equal to 1.3 Cnc plus gamma D Nq plus 0.4 gamma B N gamma. And the last one is circular footing. So the formula of circular footing is Qu equal to 1.3 Cnc plus gamma D Nq plus 0.3 gamma B N gamma. And the Terzaghi bearing capacity factor depend on soil of internal friction, and it is also depend upon angle of shearing resistance of soil, that is phi. In this slide, I have discussed about Terzaghi's analysis assumptions. So the first assumption is the soil is homogeneous, that is uniform in compositions throughout, and isotropic. Second is the soil is fully saturated. Third one is the solid particles are incompressible. Fourth one is compressions and flow are one dimensional. Fifth one is strain in the soil are relatively small. Next is Darcy's law is valid for all hydraulic gradient. Next, the coefficient of permeability and the coefficient of volume compressibility remain constant throughout the process. And the last one is there is a unique relationships independence of time between the void ratio and the effective stress. In this slide, I have discussed about the type of bearing capacity failure. The bearing capacity failure depending on the stiffness of foundation soil and depth of foundation. The following modes of shear failure is categorized, that is first is general shear failure, second one is local shear failure, and third one is punching shear failure. So first we have to know general shear failure. This type of failure is seen in dense and stiff soil. So The first point in general shear failure, that is, continuous, well-defined and distinct failure surface developed between the edge of footing and ground surface. Second, dense or stiff soil that undergoes low compressibility experiences this failure. And third one is continuous bulging of shear mass adjacent to footing is visible. In this slide, I have discussed about the local shear failure. This type of failure is seen in relatively loose and soft soil. The following are some characteristics of local shear failure. So the first point is a significant compression of soil below the footing and the partial development of plastic equilibrium is observed. Second is failure is not sudden and there is no tilting of footing. Third one is failure surface does not reach the ground surface and slight bulging of soil around the footing is observed. Fourth is failure surface is not well defined. Fifth is failure is characteristics by considerable settlement. Sixth is well defined peak is absence, that is P equal to, and the local shear failure is accompanied by the large strain, that is greater than 10 to 20% in a soil which considerably low phi, where phi less than 28 degree and low penetration value, that is N, and N less than 5 having low relative density or ID greater than 20%. And now I have discussed about punching shear failure. This type of failure is seen in loose and soft soil at the deeper elevations. The following are some characteristics in punching shear failure. So the first one is this type of failures occur in a soil is very high compressibility. Next, the bulging of soil around the footing is absent. Next is failure is characteristics by the very large settlement. Next is continuous settlement with no increase in P is observed. In this slide, I have discussed about the difference between general shear failure and local shear failure. So the first point is, in general shear failure result in small strain, that is less than 5%, and in local shear failure result in large strain is greater than 20%. In general shear failure, failure pattern well defined and clear, and in local shear the failure pattern not well defined. In general shear failure, well defined peak in peak curve is well defined, and in local shear no peak. In bulging form in the neighborhood of footing at the surface, and is no bulging observed in the neighborhood of footing. In general shear, extent of horizontal spates of disturbance at the surface large, and in local shear extent of horizontal spate of disturbance at the surface very small. In general shear observed in shallow foundation, and in local shear observed in deep foundation. In general shear failure is sudden and catastrophic, and in local shear failure is gradual. In general shear the less settlement but tilting failure observed, but in local shear failure considerable settlement of footing is observed.